So a common complication and side effect of contact lens wear is something called a giant papillary conjunctivitis, or GPC, and can cause irritation with contact lenses and can make your vision blurry and things don't sit right. So in this video, we're gonna break down what a GPC is, as well as the possible treatments your doctor may recommend. That's today's video. Let's take a look. Hey, what's up everyone? This is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn all about the eyes, vision, and finding the best vision products. If you're new here to the channel, definitely hit that subscribe button down below so that you don't miss any of the future videos, and let's just dive right into it. So chances are, if you're watching this video, it's because your doctor diagnosed you or told you you had GPC, or giant papillary conjunctivitis. This is often caused by contact lenses, but can also be caused by other things, like prosthetic eyes or any sort of other chronic foreign body on the eye, maybe a suture from a surgical procedure that was left on the eye. This can also lead to something like a GPC. Now, a giant papillary conjunctivitis is essentially just a swelling of part of your eyelid, most commonly the upper eyelid. Now, for basically anybody out there, you can develop a just normal papillary conjunctivitis that's not giant. Most commonly, we see this due to things like allergies, possible bacterial infections of the eye, or in general, just inflammation of the eyelid itself. But most often, in the eye clinic, we see a GPC form due to contact lens wear. And you might think, well, why is this happening to contact lenses? Am I allergic to the contact lens itself? Usually not. Most of the people who get a GPC are people who wear contact lenses a lot. These are individuals who wear them 16 plus hours throughout the day. Could be somebody who overwears their lenses, especially if they're wearing a 2 week or a monthly lens and they're wearing them for a lot longer than they should be. Or if you're somebody who sleeps in a contact lens, or somebody who doesn't clean your contact lenses appropriately. What happens is that your contact lenses, they sit on the eye for a long period of time, and the proteins in your tears, they attract to the surface of that contact lens, and you build up a biofilm on the surface of those lenses. And your body starts to not only develop an allergic reaction to those proteins, but basically to the chronic presence of that contact lens sitting on the eye. And in addition to these proteins on the contact lens, a poor fitting contact lens on the eye can also be part of the reason why this could be aggravating the upper eyelid. And that's exactly why an exposed suture from an eye surgery or maybe a prosthetic eye can also cause these sort of GPCs. Now, a GPC looks different than just your typical allergic response on the eyelid. These GPCs are giant, they are large, and they look kind of gross or can have a kind of what's called a cobblestone appearance. Now, your doctor will recognize this and diagnose this condition oftentimes by flipping or everting the upper eyelid. It's not a painful procedure. You maybe see kids or remember kids on the playground who would flip their eyelids inside out. It's essentially the same procedure. We just ask the patient to look down. We use something like a cotton-tipped applicator or a Q-tip, and we push that on the upper tarsal plate, and we flip the eyelid inside out. This is often a best practice for all eye doctors to do this on patients who do wear contact lenses, especially people who wear monthlies or bi-weekly contacts. People who wear daily contact lenses, because they're replacing the new lens every single day, they aren't carrying forward those same proteins to the next day, and they're less likely to have these sort of aggravations or problems with GPCs. Either way, if you ever get diagnosed with a GPC, the best practices that most doctors will recommend is 1, staying out of your contacts. Give them a break. Usually you have to take a break from contact lenses and just switch to glasses for maybe a couple of weeks, sometimes a little bit longer, closer to a month or more, depending on how severe it is and how quickly the inflammatory reaction comes down. In addition, your doctor could prescribe a topical steroid eye drop or ointment that will help control the inflammation and bring it down quite a bit. Ultimately, a couple tips for you that your doctor will probably recommend anyway is that if you are having a GPC or have a history of them and you are still wearing a monthly or bi-weekly lens, and if you could switch to a single-use daily contact lens, that is probably going to be a better option, again, less chance of a GPC. Or your doctor, unfortunately, could say, you know what, we have to completely quit contact lenses altogether, stick with glasses, or consider something like refractive surgery such as LASIK or PRK. Oftentimes, in my experience, people who have GPCs often need to remain out of contact lenses or use additional treatments for at least 2 to 4 weeks. I've even had some patients to have to stay out of contact lenses for up to 3 months for this to really calm down. But oftentimes those are individuals who abuse their contact lenses. They're wearing the same like bi-weekly contact for like 3 months, sleeping in them, and their cornea is warped and have all other complications. Hopefully, if you're watching this and you just know that that's you, then it's time to be a little bit more serious about taking care of your contacts. And I know I've said this across a lot of different videos on this channel before, but it is a higher risk of complications from sleeping or overwearing your contact lenses. And I do have a video about a time I accidentally slept in my contacts, and I go over some of the other risk factors of why sleeping in contacts is not a good idea. If you want to check out that video, you can go ahead and click or tap the screen up here to the sign, or I'll include a link to that in the video description below, just again, so you can learn a little bit more about what's going on in the eye. Otherwise, another quick tip that I know helps some people, if you're somebody who wears a monthly or a bi-weekly contacts and maybe a daily contact lens isn't out there for you, or it's just not in the financial bucket right now for you to be able to afford a daily contact lens, then cleaning your contact lenses with a hydrogen peroxide solution such as Clear Care. I've had several patients have good results with just switching from a multi-purpose solution to more of the hydrogen peroxide solution because there's no preservatives in a hydrogen peroxide solution. And you could be someone who's just hypersensitive to preservatives in the other solution, so maybe giving that a try. Otherwise, I hope you found this video educational and helpful. If so, smash that like button for me and leave a comment in the section below about your experience with GPC or giant papillary conjunctivitis, if you've had it before, how long did it take to treat it, and if you have any other general questions about contact lenses, go ahead and check out my full series about contact lenses and the different options that are available. Otherwise, again, thanks so much for watching. This is Dr. Joseph Allen here from Dr. Eye Health. Keep an eye on it, and we'll talk to you soon. Known as a GPC. It is, okay. Nerds.